Yes, we got to have an absolute. I'm thinking of one right now as I'm closing. Would be George Washington when America was young. And we were fighting for life, the life of this great nation that we have. George Washington was a Christian. He was a believer. And down at Valley Forge, I'm told that the American soldiers only had about one-third of them had on shoes. And the winter was cold and the zero weather and the river frozen and gorging over and the British on the other side and the life of this little nation was at hand. What did he do? He was a Christian. He goes out in the nighttime and kneels down in the snow and prays until he was wet with snow water up around his waistline. And he stayed there and prayed until he got the absolute, the answer from God, that God was going to give him the victory. And the next day, Valley Forge was nothing to him. He crossed the Delaware, pushed through the ice with half-dressed soldiers, half-frozen, their bare feet on the ground in the snow, and he took it when three rifle bullets went through his coat. Why? He was trusting in the absolute of an answered prayer. Amen. Very backgrounds of our nation based upon such a thing. What's the matter with people today who claim to be Christians? Why are we disturbed in an hour like this? Let's not be disturbed. Let's be soldiers. Yes, sir, he prayed until he got that answer that no clouded river, no bare feet soldiers, regardless of the circumstance, they could take it because God had said so. A bullet couldn't even kill him for an enemy's rival. Certainly, why, it had a prayer meeting. He got the answer. How well it was one night when Apostle Peter was in the jail and they were going to kill him the next morning. He was going to die under capital punishment as this little Jew's going to do now. But what did they do? They did the same thing that we here in Houston are trying to do. They formed a prayer meeting at John Mark's house. While they were praying, the angel of the Lord went to the prison and opened up the prison bars and opened the gates, and beyond that led Peter out and come right down to the prayer meeting. I believe tonight that that same God lives. If he isn't the same God, then there's something wrong. Certainly, what was it done? By a prayer meeting, by faithful Christians who believe and believe that God would deliver their brother from capital punishment. Them were Christians who stayed all night and laid up on their faces and cried out and prayed. As I heard one of the ministers a while ago saying, he's going to cry out all night long. The trouble of it is today, people let down. They get tired, sleepy. They can't even sit through a 10-minute service hardly. It's something wrong. If you love God, well, we should be busy. It should be our hopes, our desires. It should be everything that's in us should be in the love of Christ. Amen. We sit so slothful. We sit so unconcerned when the world's dying under our feet. That's right. Man's lives going out without God. And we sit so unconcerned about it. As long as we belong to the church, that's all we think. It makes a difference. I was talking about the coming of Christ a few weeks ago in a certain church. And afterwards, someone met me in the back of the church and said, "Brother Branham, you scare people to death." I said, "Why did I do that?" He said, "Well, you're talking about the coming of Christ. I don't want to hear such things as that. I got a little boy here I got to raise. I got a girl in school." Well, I said, "The coming of Christ is the most glorious thing I can think of." Certainly. See, the Bible said, all those who love his appearing. Whoa, my, for a day that when this old marvel will take on immortality in this pest house that I live in will be changed in a moment, in a twinkling of an eye, and a body like his own glorious body. It should be the heart's desire of the church. It should be every man and woman on fire preaching the streets and everywhere else trying to get souls saved. Certainly, I'm wondering if we've really tied to that absolute that we claim to. Are we looking at the right morning star? If we're just trusting in our church and our denomination, our affiliation, as the world changes, it changes with that. Round and around, but there's one star that never changed. There's one thing that can never change. That's God. God cannot change. His Word cannot change. His Bible cannot change. And if a man is born of the Spirit of God with Christ in him, it punctuates every promise with an amen. That is right. Certainly.